total exposure to the sun and the air. So why not the sea? Nudist slipped the goggles down over her mouth until she had again been reassured by Sandy that there were no sharks waiting to spoil her aquatic journey. Approach they had to most of nature's elements. The scuba gear was limited in quantity, so the nudists, in their usual way, shaped a clumsy, awkward land creature into a transformed, graceful sea urchin. The world underwater is like an magical powers. The human being is able to adapt surprisingly well to this physical at first and then visual transformation. The water has a both relaxing and invigorating effect on the body. Very shortly, the technical job of breathing properly was no longer a problem, and the heaviness of the tank was no longer felt. Thank you. station to start picking up corals and sponges from the bottom of the sea to take back to the surface. But Sandy had warned everyone beforehand that unless one was an expert in oceanography, the delicate, irresistible object so accessible to one's hand might turn out to be a poison coral or some such formidable thing. The sensual feeling of the water and its